The second natural resource that we are going to study is water. As you can see over here, there are glories of water. It has been glorified. There are the points, and it has been mentioned that water is the use of water. You can see a water body, very good looking. And what are the uses? What is its significance? Let's talk about it one by one. 3/4 of Earth's surface is covered with water. We know that 70% of Earth is either ocean water or fresh water. Now, if the entire Earth's water is taken, only 1% is fresh water that is required by the terrestrial beings. Rest all is salt water, you know that. It is one of the most important natural resources, needless to say. All living things depend on water. Now, whether an organism is aquatic or it is terrestrial, it has to depend on water. How it depends on water? That all the cellular activity takes place inside the medium known as water only. From one place to another, if the nutrient has to pass, it would pass in water. The cell itself would work if it is having water inside it. And for all these surviving tactics, the saline water is not necessary. Saline water would not suffice. And because we are terrestrial beings, not just we, there are so many terrestrial beings, they require fresh water because it is not easy for the living beings to get rid of such salt content if they consume salt water in the quantities that otherwise is being consumed in the quantities of fresh water. So all living things, they depend on water, and for that dependence, if the organism is terrestrial, it has to depend on fresh water. It is also used in household purposes. Like now we have come from the entire biological world into the human uses, human utility, that it is also used in household purposes like cleaning, cooking, washing, drinking, bathing, etc. Many uses are there. Now, this is what is we know about water. We have studied about water. We have talked about water, about these things. You have mentioned, if ever you are giving some topic to write about the importance of water. Water is a wonder liquid. You can call it that way. But what you're going to see is this. This is what this wonder liquid is being subjected to these days at maximum of the places. Recently, you must have heard about that World Environment Day was dedicated to reducing plastic pollution in water bodies, especially ocean plastic pollution. What you see over here is badly polluted water body, and human beings are, I think, looking for fish in it, or otherwise they are trying to clean it. If they are trying to clean it, then it is really good. It's a good picture. If they are trying to fish out of it, you can very well imagine, if you consume such a fish which is being fished from this water, what kind of health implications it can bring to you. Now, you see, this water body and water pollution we have to deal with. Water pollution can be caused in different ways. First is that we add enough organic matter into the water body, which leads to the death of living organisms inside it. See, we know we need fresh water, we need it pure. You must be knowing by now that you need not to take contaminated water because it brings many diseases. Everybody has to survive with water. Even the viruses and microbes which come and infest you when you consume the contaminated water, they also have to survive in water. So it's better you just take another path, you filter your water and consume it. But what about those organisms which do not have these water filters and purification mechanisms at their dispense? If you are destroying their habitat, then also you're doing the pollution, because as I told you, pollution is anything undesirable in the water body, so it would be water pollution. Now, in the case of water pollution, first of all, let's talk about that we use many fertilizers and many pesticides in our agriculture field. They would ultimately go into the water body. If not in the water body, that is on the ground surface, at least it would be seeping down into the aquifers that are present underground water I'm talking about. So we are adding the poisonous content into the underground water, or we are adding the poisonous content into the rivers and lakes. And if that poisonous content goes and kills the life forms inside that living body, that is pollution automatically. We are adding plastics, we are just depriving the water body of dissolved oxygen. If we are doing that also, then also the organisms will not be able to survive. So dissolved oxygen, taking away the dissolved oxygen, is also a type of water pollution that could be done by adding some unwanted life form into the water. Okay, and then we have supposedly you increase the temperature of the water body. You know, these thermal plants and factories, whatever waste material they dispose into water, it is often at high temperature. As a result, what happens, the water body into which they are thrown, these waste outlets are thrown, they have a rise in their temperature. And when there is rise in temperature, the organisms which are accustomed to staying in that water, they have to accommodate to that change, and often they are not accommodated to that change and they perish. So you can make it out that how important water pollution is for all the life forms in adverse way. It's not important in a good way, it's important in a bad way. So we must try every possible way to stop water pollution and just contribute minimum deal from our level. And what you see over here is totally disheartening. Try not to be a part of it, because as I told you, water is a wonder liquid. In our culture, we call it that water is the essence of life, and it is truly said that no living organism can survive without water. The cells need a water atmosphere to work properly, and that is fulfilled by fresh water. Nowadays, not even the saline water is immune to the pollution. It has been polluted to a great extent by the plastic waste that is being thrown into the oceans. So we need to take a step forward and stop this huge menace of water pollution if we need to survive in a better way, in harmony with the nature.